Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will introduce the idea of drug space, which is critical for drug discovery. After watching this video, students will be able to define drug-like space, specifically for oral drugs, define compound libraries, and outline the process of screening a library of compounds for on-target activity. Here is a box. This box contains all molecules that we might consider as potential drugs. The molecules in this box include both drugs and molecules that resemble drugs, drug-like molecules. To put some limits on this box, this drug-like space, we are focused on oral drugs. In general, oral drugs tend to have around 30 heavy atoms. These are atoms excluding hydrogens. The molecular weight of these compounds often falls in the 400 to 500 gram per mole range. Nobody knows how many molecules are in this space, but it is huge. One estimate from the reference on this slide says there could be 10 to the 63 molecules. How do we think about this drug-like space as a way to find drugs? Let's say that we are developing a drug with a known molecular target. Most of this drug-like space contains compounds with no appreciable activity. Dead space. There will be islands of weakly active compounds, and these islands will include our hits and actives. Each island represents groups of molecules that are structurally similar to each other. Within the hit regions, some compounds might have good enough activity, good enough properties, to be leads. The blue regions, much smaller. Finally, some of the lead spaces may contain viable drugs in dark green. The location of hit spaces, lead spaces, and drug spaces change if you look at different targets, because a different target will bind to molecules with different structures. Here again is our drug-like space. How do we find these hit, lead, and drug spaces? Drug companies use libraries of molecules, sometimes called compound collections. By testing molecules in these libraries for on-target activity through an in vitro assay, you can hopefully find molecules with promising activity, actives. The libraries can be huge, even millions of molecules, so the entire process is automated with robots. When the technology of the assay works well with robotic automation, then you have a high-throughput screen, or HTS. And the library can be quickly screened to discover actives for additional evaluation. Let's see how this works. We have a 25 compound library, unrealistically small. Each compound is a black dot, and the library uniformly samples our drug-like space. We have three possible regions of actives or hits. Our library overlaps with two of them, but we just missed this hit space at the bottom. With some structural modifications, we can explore space around these hits and discover leads. With continued exploration and optimization, we might find molecules that lie within these drug spaces. Molecules with suitable potency, efficacy, PK, and safety to be advanced into the clinic and possibly become a drug. So the library and the diversity of compounds in the library reveal to the discovery team regions of possible activity to focus the early research efforts of the discovery program. We have now defined drug-like space as well as compound libraries. We have also outlined how libraries are used to screen for activity within drug-like space. I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, if you have any questions, do not hesitate to ask them in the comments section below the video. Take care.